name is Nathan Morris, and today I want to inform you about racing dogs. Now, let's go back to when it all started. Now, racing dogs started in September 11, 1876. Now, of course, they've been racing dogs a long time before this, but that was for fun. Betting and actually for a big competition started in 1876. Now, this is when they also started doing artificial lures instead of real animals like foxes, rabbits, squirrels, and sometimes raccoons. But that is illegal now, and it's all artificial. Now, this is also when they raced six dogs at a time instead of eight, which they do now. And here's a picture of a greyhound going out of the starter pen. Now, let's talk a little about where does dog racing take place. Now, there's 10 states where dog racing is legal. In those states, and six of those states is where dog racing is operational and they can still run them. And those states are Alabama, Arkansas, Florida, Iowa, Texas, and West Virginia. Now, the other four states, dog racing is legal, but unfortunately, dog tracks are unoperational. And the other 40 states, dog racing is totally illegal, and which you cannot race dogs in. And the red states show where dog racing is illegal. The yellow states show where dog racing is non-operational, and the green states show where dog racing is fully legal. Now, talk about the pros and cons about dog racing. Pros is dog racing provides a whole lot of jobs for a lot of people. Also, another pro is that dog racing provides a livelihood for trainers and dog breeders. Now, this is awesome. And one of my favorite parts is going and seeing the races. And this dog races provide a time for family and friends to truly bond and get together to watch these dogs do amazing things that are nearly really impossible. Now, here's a dog trainer cuddling with his dog. Now it's time to talk about the cons. And the cons are betting and gambling. Now, usually this brings a bad crowd around most of the times, but it also brings profit in for the dog tracks and the trainers. So that's a con and a pro at the same time. Now, the live baiting, most of this has to do with actually running real animals, like for the dogs to chase after. Like I said, raccoons, rabbits, foxes, and also squirrels sometimes, not most of the times, but sometimes. So this has a lot for animal rights groups protest about this. And this also has something to do with the poor treatment of animals, both the animals that they chase and the dogs. So it's just a hard time all the way around. And here is a picture of greyhounds in a cage. Now this is more in the dark part of greyhound racing. Now let's talk about what dog breed is really selected to race, or bred for this. And there's two kinds of dogs that they race. One type, they race greyhounds. And the other type, they race wiener dogs. But we're not gonna really talk about that today. We're mostly gonna talk about greyhounds. And greyhounds are one of the fastest domesticated dogs in the world. And they are fast because they have long legs, a slender body, and a sharp face. Really, it's very aerodynamic, and they can glide through the air. Now, the strides and the technique allow them to go faster at high speeds, to reach these high speeds. All about their legs and how they move against the ground. Now, they rely on their eyesight. Their eyesight is everything. Without it, they can't really race. And most dogs rely on their sense of smell, sense of hearing, but greyhounds, all on their eyesight. And here's a picture of them racing. Now, let's talk about greyhounds in history. Now, greyhounds were used throughout history for many different things, but mostly for companions. For the Egyptians, they were companions and pets. And you can see that most of their sculptures and artworks. And, bones of the greyhounds have been found in the pharaoh's tombs, most pharaohships throughout history. Then we have painting and sculptures. Now, this is really cool because there's so many different paintings and sculptures of greyhounds throughout history. They show wealth, they show strength, and they also show speed. And the greyhounds are a status of wealth. Also, they are also the only dog breed mentioned in the Bible. Now, this is really cool. Proverbs 30:29-31 is amazing. And here are some pictures of the dogs. Shows a sign of wealth. Shows monkeys on the backs. That was just a fun thing in history. And different dogs. Now, interesting facts about greyhounds is they are the oldest dog breed in history. Greyhounds are bred to hunt and chase. They have a great peripheral vision. Fun word. They have a universal blood type, which they donate to different dog clinics. They can run 45 miles per hour. Greyhounds hunt with their eyes, not with their nose, or not with their ears. And here's a picture. Thank you.
6 minutes and 16 seconds.
6 minutes and 16 seconds. Barely over. Not much, but barely.